development. Since the 1950s, China has been providing us 9-year compulsory education to what amount to a fifth of the world's population. In 1999, the primary school education had become the generalized. In 1990s of China, the mandatory 9-year compulsory education now effectively covered 85% population, while the central and provincial governments provide some funding for education. This varies from province to province, and funding in the rural areas is notably lower than the in major urban municipalities. Families must supplementary money provided to this school by the government with the tuition fees, which means that some children have much less. However, parents place a very high value on education and make great personal sacrifice to send their children to school and universities. Literacy in the young and the mid-ages population has fallen from over 80% down to 5%. The system trained some 60 million mid or high level professionals and near 400 million laborers to the junior or a senior high school level. Today, 250 million Chinese get 3 levels of the school's education: elementary, junior, senior high school level, doubling the rate of increasing in the rest of the world. During the same period, the net elementary schools enrollment has reached 98.9% and the cross enrollment rate in junior high schools 94.1%. China educational horizon are expanding. In 1980s, the MBA was virtually unknown, but by 2004 there were 47,000 MBAs trained at 62 MBA schools. Many people also apply for international professional qualifications such as the EMBA and the MPA. Close to the 10,000 MPA students are enrolled in the 47 schools of higher learning, including the Peking University and the Hangzhou University. The education market has rocketed with the training and testing the professional qualifications such as the computer and foreign languages. Thriving continuing education is the trend. Once in one life, schooling has become the lifelong learning. International cooperation and education exchange increase every year. China has more students studying abroad than any other country. Since 1979, there have been 6,997,000 Chinese students studying in 103 countries and region of the world. 185,000 having returning after the finishing their studies. The number of the foreign students studying in China has increased rapidly. In 2004, over 110,000 students from the 178 countries were studying at China's universities. Investment in the education has increased in recent years. The proportion of the overall budget allocated to the education has been increased by 1% point every year since the 1998. According to the Minister of Education Program, the government will set up an educational finance system in line with the public finance system, strengthen the responsibilities of the government at all levels in the education system, and ensure that their financial allocation for educational expenditure grows faster than their regular revenue. The program also set out the government's aim that the educational investment should account for 4% of GDP in the relatively short period of time. For non-compulsory education, China adopts a share cost mechanism, charging tuition at a certain percentage of the cost. Meanwhile, to ensure that the students from the low-income families have access to the higher education, the government has initiated effective ways of assistance with the policies and measure the scholarship, work study program, subsidies, and the students with special economic difficulties, tuition reduction or exemption and a state stipend. The government has committed itself to markedly raise the educational level generally, and evidence in the Ministry of the Education program by 2020 of every 100,000 people, 13,500 will have had a junior college education or above, and some 31,000 will have the had senior high school. Schooling rates for illiteracy and semi-literacy rate will fall below 3%, and average schooling duration across the population will increase from today's 8 years to nearly 11 years. In the 2009 test of the program for international student assessment, a worldwide evaluation of the 15-year-old schooling pupils psychologist performed by the OECD, Chinese student from the Shanghai achieving the best result in the mathematics, science and reading. The OECD also found that even in some of the very poor rural areas, the performance is close to OECD average. However, controversy has surrounded the high score achieved by the Chinese student due to the unusual spread of the numerical data, with suggestion that the schools were gaming students. for the exams, while average across the breadth of the other countries are reported. China ranking are taken from the only a few select districts.